Alright, all you glorious gamers out there, and welcome to PlayersToo Reacts to Gamescom's Opening Night Live. And with me as always, and in person for the first time in a very long time, Mr. Lewis Camley. How's it going, Lewis?
It's going very well, Mark. Yeah, nice to be here, nice to be invited over to watch this together and do some of our kind of live reactions to it.
Yeah, very excited for this, Lewis. What are you expecting from the show?
Honestly, as we kind of said a few weeks ago, not a hell of a lot, I've got to say. I mean, these shows can be hit and miss. There's bound to be a few games that will appeal to us. I think there'll be plenty for other people that won't be for us. But I've got to say, like, normally I wouldn't be expecting too much. Geoff Keighley has told us quite a few things that are
so many things. He's told us so many goddamn things.
He kind of can't help himself sometimes. We know that there's going to be about 35 games on show, and he's tweeted out a list of about, I don't know, 12 or so, maybe more than that. That included things like Borderlands, Dying Light 2, Genshin Impact, Gotham Knights, Hogwarts Legacy, Lies of P, which I'm quite excited to see actually, Goat Simulator 3, High on Life, Honkai Star Rail, Return to Monkey Island, Sonic Frontiers, Callisto Protocol, The Expanse, the Telltale series, The Outlast Trials, and an Unknown Worlds new IP. So there's already quite a few things there of a certain scale. What are you excited about out of that list?
I've got to say, I am quite excited to find out whatever the Unknown Worlds new IP is. That is the creator of Subnautica, right?
Yeah, that's right.
Callisto Protocol, obviously, every single time it's at a showcase. I want to see it, basically. High on Life as well, to be honest with you. Justin Roiland's project. Very, very interested in that. And Lies of P as well, which is just one of the most bizarre looking things in gaming I think I've ever seen. So, yeah, very, very much excited to see all of that, to be honest with you. But, Lewis, the showcase is about to start. Here we go. As 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and we are beginning. Come on, Geoff. What have you got for us?
Yeah, give us the goods, Geoff. It's time for a really killer summer show, which I don't think we're going to get, but...
Well, me neither, but high hopes, Liz. Let's go out with high hopes. Long intro, Geoff, I've got to say. Long intro to this.
Please welcome to
to the stage.
Live crowd as well.
Straight to the stage.
Keighley!
And the crowd goes wild. There he is in a very casual jacket.
Oh my god, hello everybody! How you doing? It is so great to have a live crowd with us here in Cologne, Germany. For Gamescom 2022, I'm Geoff Keighley, and I gotta say, I am so excited to be here with you. We did this in 2019, live in person in Germany, and then the past 2 years, we had to do it virtually from Los Angeles, and in 2020,
walk out already.
The first time we together live was that August, Gamescom, and we connected with all of you virtually, and the fact that we're back here in person, I don't want to ever take this for granted before. So, guys, are you ready for a fun show?
Yes, come on, Geoff. Give us a fun show.
I gotta say, we have a lot of great stuff for you tonight. We have tons of world premieres. The entire industry has come together to showcase the future for you. We've got games like Sonic Frontiers, the Callisto Protocol.
Oh, we didn't need to read the list.
He's gonna do it. Yeah.
And a lot of surprises.
Imagine opening with Sonic Frontiers of that list, though.
Here at Gamescom.
Oh, I don't like to be rude about Sonic,
but... I can't wait to get started. We've got 2 hours of stuff, so should we...
This trailer would have to be something special to get me excited about that game.
Yeah. Yeah. I think we'll get a release date for that tonight, though.
Oh, that's a good joke. That's a good joke.
A live crowd. We got to surprise you with some stuff tonight, too. So let's start things off with our first world premiere. It's a new world from a brand new team that has a bold vision. Let's check this out.
Very interesting.
New team, new vision.
Love it.
We want the community to build this.
Oh, shit.
Their worlds. We want them to tell their stories.
This is Leslie Benzies from Rockstar. That's insane. Oh, wow. Who is a Scottish man.
Yeah.
We're free to explore, to be creative.
This game's been in development for fucking donkeys, man.
The goals are to make an experience that's unlike any other, which is such an exciting thing to be part of.
I think ultimately, like, that's kind of been the big ambition, is to create this kind of like open world that can be built out in every direction.
I think it's every day is a new discovery, and it's constantly growing.
We've put a lot of focus, I think, on the current zeitgeist and what it means to represent yourself digitally. This is more than a game. It's a labor of love. It's a labor of passion.
The dream is to create a whole new world for the next generation of gamers, and I think that we've kind of captured that.
Players will play a massive part in this. It's not going to be just our game. It's not going to be just what we decide to do with it.
There's something in it that will definitely appeal to you, no matter what it is that you love to do.
The really thrilling aspect of all this is that people are going to get to see what we're doing for the first time.
I'm just so excited for people to see what we've been spending the last 5 years pouring our hearts and souls into.
I think that's three Scottish accents in the first trailer, Liz.
Yeah, they will have to wait just a little bit longer.
Always nice to hear.
This is a lovely concept, though, but everything that they're saying is so vague. It does not feel like this can be a game that's anywhere close to coming out.
Well, are they going to show us it now, or is this just going to be a title card? Feels like this might be a title card. I think this game was called Everything. Like, literally, I like genuinely think that might be true. Just like an MMO vibe.
Oh.
That had taken a turn though. Everywhere. I was close.
Everywhere, anything, who knows? Doesn't feel like they do yet.
It feels like in terms of scope, they have went exceptionally big.
Yeah, it definitely does. I mean, that's given me kind of massive, like, Battle Royale vibes, to be honest, but who knows what it's going to be.
Totally.
And joining me now from Build a Rocket Boy is Adam Whiting to hopefully answer some of those, because we're a little confused, but we want to know a lot about this. So tell us, Everywhere, what kind of game is this? What can you tell us, Adam?
Well, firstly, can I just say it's really exciting to just be here, and we've been looking forward to coming out of stealth mode and really delighted to start the conversation today here at Gamescom. Now, I won't be able to reveal everything, but what I can say is that really we're not trying to make a normal game. I think the scope and ambition of this project are quite unlike anything else. We want to build a whole new world for gamers, and not just a place to play, but watch, share, create, hang out with your friends, and so much more.
Well, oh, that sounded metaversy. That sounded metaversy. Oh no. Red flags. Red flags, Liz.
I don't want to do any of those things. I just want to play video games.
Well, Geoff, that's one of the many surprises we've got in store for players. I mean, we are passionate about making games and telling stories, but ultimately we made Everywhere to be a place where players can make their own experiences, be who they want to be and tell their own stories. But we're still passionate about making immersive and cinematic experiences that players can just get lost in and enjoy. I guess you could say we want people to have their cake and eat it, and Everywhere is the place that can happen.
All right, well, definitely a bold vision for what you're doing here. The other question I'm sure we're all wondering is, we didn't see any date on the trailer, any sense of when we're going to get to play this thing? Where are you at in development?
Well, I'm delighted to say that we aim to have Everywhere in the hands of players in 2023, but we've got many more things to show and tell over the coming months, and we're really excited for you to sign up on our website, everywhere.game. But really, today was just a sneak peek behind the curtain to see what the team has been so hard at work on, and we're really excited to get this in the hands of players as soon as possible.
Amazing. Well,
a
Adam,
sneak peek indeed. I'm not
sure
I got very much from that trailer, to be honest.
I don't think that is coming in 2023.
No, me neither. Me neither. But that game has been in development for ages.
Yeah.
Since Leslie Benzies fell away from Rockstar, like, yeah. I think that he started that studio relatively quickly after that, and that game has been in development ever since.
Nice. Another world premiere here.
Funcom.
I'm legendary.
Interesting.
Fear is the mind killer.
Very nice graphics if that's an engine. It's got UE5 written all over it, if you ask me.
Is the little death that brings total obliteration.
Oh, I think this might be June.
You know, when those things flew past, I was like, oh, this is giving me like a sort of June vibe, but it is literally June.
Yeah.
See, I don't know enough about June to
recognize
these things immediately.
Yeah.
The graphics on that dude's hair are very impressive.
Going for a ride on the big worm?
Certainly. Why wouldn't you, Lewis? Why wouldn't you? Fair play, man.
Yeah. So this isn't the RTS that we already knew about, right?
No, that's new. Yeah, yeah, yeah. That was called, like, the... I can't remember. Spice Wars or something. Like that. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
An open-world survival MMO.
Could have done without it being an MMO, if I'm totally honest, Liz.
Trust me, the fun is just beginning tonight.
Are fantastic graphics. That will be trailer only. I cannot imagine that that... will translate to an MMO terribly well.
For all the fans come together here at Gamescom, and right now I'm honored to share this global PlayStation announcement with you right here at Gamescom.
I thought PlayStation weren't going to be here. Interesting.
Yeah, I think the messaging around this is tricksy, to say the least. Oh, it's going to be PSVR 2, isn't it, that they just announced?
Oh, of course it is, yeah. Of course it is. Or is it?
Oh.
Oh, is this like an Elite controller? Oh, fucking no. Oh, this is fantastic. I'm very much into this. I mean, don't get me wrong, this is multiple years behind Xbox, but nonetheless, I'm very glad that it is now here.
Jules says Edge,
and it looks like a chunky boy. It's a big chunky boy.
There you go. The DualSense Edge. It's a high-performance, ultra-customizable wireless PlayStation 5 controller designed by PlayStation, and you see there you can have your own custom control profiles customized to your playstyle. If you guys want to learn more about the brand new controller, you can head to PlayStation blog and thank
Lewis, do you know what the saddest thing about that announcement is? Is that I'm definitely going to end up buying one of them, and they're definitely going to be very expensive.
I've never massively seen the point, but you know, for the type of games that I play, I suppose.
Yeah, I mean, don't get me wrong, I've got an Xbox Elite up there, and fuck me, it's a good controller.
All the way over in the middle of development to Gamescom, we really appreciate it. How has the response been to Callisto so far?
Man, Geoff, the response has been fantastic for a new IP. I couldn't ask for anything more.
Big Glenn Schofield.
Fans, and I want to thank my team for just really killing it.
Must admit, I think this is now the third or fourth time I've seen Glenn Schofield recently, and he never has a jacket that fits him.
We're going to get to that in a second. You brought some gameplay. We saw some great stuff at Summer Game Fest. You brought more now. What are we going to see today, Glenn?
Yeah, you've got some live gameplay. We've got two sections. The first one is going to show some crazy combat. And the second one is something new from the game. A little different than what we've shown, with a pretty crazy ending.
Yes, it is. You guys are going to love
very
this.
Good. Double
is
crazy.
Is it going to be violent and scary?
Double crazy.
In that game, we love the strategic dismemberment. I understand you're kind of one-upping things for this game.
Well, we got dismemberment, and we've shown the gore system. And today
the gore system. Lovely stuff.
We've got dismemberment.
So the enemies may sometimes have these tentacles that come out. And if you don't shoot them, take them out on time, this guy in real time is going to mutate in front of you into something bigger, badder, faster, meaner, and he's going to be taking you out. It's pretty cool.
Well, this is one of my most anticipated.
I mean, that does sound cool, but it also sounds very like Resident Evil. I don't think that's a particularly new idea, right?
Let's take a look at brand new gameplay from the
Callisto
Protocol. Let's see how it pans out.
Not really, but yeah, I mean, but nonetheless, this game looks cool. This game looks cool.
Okay, we can't say anything about it.
Oh, no, we can't. We can say many bad things about it, but it does look good. I'm just like, right, okay, he's explaining one of the mechanics as if it's a unique thing, but it's not.
Maybe
the game looks cool, so it's fine.
Maybe it'll be different.
Is this the first time we've seen gameplay like this, like an actual stretch of gameplay? I know that we've seen like snippets of gameplay here and there.
Yeah, well, we saw a bit, because didn't we see a bit that had this kind of machinery in it before, where at the end of the trailer you get kind of pulled into it, much like that man just has. But I don't know if we've kind of seen it, you know, as hopefully as fully as this is going to be, at least.
Yeah, I must admit, the minute you pointed that out, I was like, oh shit, yeah, that does look familiar.
Some nice stealth action here.
Yeah, man. I like the zoomf gun.
Yeah.
The zoomf gun's great.
It feels a wee bit control that or something. Is,
Some sort of powers
going on in these guns.
So that dude had tentacles, but he shot them now. I guess that's what he was talking about.
Oh. He's...
Use him as a weapon.
Use done
weapon.
Something crazy with that guy as well.
I use him as a shield. I think he was doing
so
that.
He can kind of take possession of people or sort of freeze them somehow with his weaponry. I keep saying people as if these things are people, but they...
Yeah, mad zombie things.
That
one also doesn't have a head, and it's
still going.
Bucking the zombie trend, though.
I guess they're sort of alien zombies, right? Oh,
yeah.
More tentacles.
Okay, right. Let's
see
what
happens. Don't kill him, is he going to go wild?
I guess so.
Let's see it. Oh, he's sort of fixed himself.
Yeah.
And it's maybe slightly bigger than he was before, I would say.
So they just transform into a different enemy type, basically, I guess.
Maybe,
that's what
or just kind of hulk up a bit or something.
Yeah. So we're cool. I was under that, man. That looked great. That was great. I was here for that.
Maybe this is going to show us a wee bit more of that.
I think this will be like a boss or something.
Okay, sweet. So we've got sort of like a rapid section. All very...
I hope this isn't a main mechanic in the game.
Yeah. I guess maybe they're just trying to bring a bit of that sort of Uncharted spectacle to these kind of
survival horror
games, which, you know, is quite welcome, to be honest. Like, a nice section like this that injects a bit of adrenaline after, like...
Stealthing around for a long time, basically.
Exactly,
yeah.
Nice. Playing around with the pacing of it a bit.
I'm fine with that. Don't get me wrong. I'm not against this.
No.
Just as long as that... If this isn't...
Yeah.
Like, a main thing. I mean, like, I hope this isn't the surprise he was talking about. It's like, you get to slide down big tubes all the time.
Oh, there's going to be something rotten at the end of this, though, isn't there?
This has been absolutely done, though.
Yeah, he's been chopped in half, yeah.
Good grief. Was that it? Just straight murder? Straight murder there.
This is a few times that Glenn Schofield's like, oh, we've got something for you, something interesting, and it's just really horrible ways that your player character gets murdered.
Pretty good, right?
That was pretty good, Geoff.
Yeah, no,
that was pretty
right
good.
Now I want to introduce my co-host for ONL, Melly. Melly, welcome to ONL.
Thanks, Geoff. I'm so excited to be here at Gamescom. Hello, everybody. I'm your guide for tonight for all the happenings around Gamescom, and I'm really, really excited to be here because the heart of gaming is beating once again, and game devs and publishers from all around the world are making their way to Cologne to show you hundreds of new games. So if you're not here yet and still can come by, make sure to drop by, and if you can't, make sure to drop by next year because it is definitely worth a visit. And one of the highlights we have this year is
that's a bit of a cool thing for us to go in.
No, at some point, yeah.
That's a bit of a cool thing for us to go in. It's not that far away.
Nah,
in comparison to like
E3.
Anyway.
Yeah.
Most original and fantastic and creative games here. And if you're not here, and
I love that Geoff is like, this is my co-host.
You can also
I'm introducing
her
some 20 minutes into the show.
Geoff, back to you.
Got to have his moment.
Thank you, Melly, and you'll be with us all night. We've got Gamescom Awards to come and other things too.
Gamescom Awards,
right?
Oh,
they always do that, though. It's like they do E3 Awards and all that shit as well.
For a long time to see, let's take a look at this brand new world premiere.
Okay, what have you got,
Geoff? It's been a strong start, mate.
After an age of the cruelest tyranny, man finally defeated its overlord. The gods do not fall forever. The champions of war united and began the eternal watch.
Hexworks is ringing a bell.
Tyrant's colossal remains. For some forces, even death cannot end. But now, eons later, the fallen gods' influence pervades the world again,
corrupting even sworn enemies. Join his accursed lords of the fallen and damn humanity to a new age of devastation. Though from these darkest days, new heroes arise. To defy the gods, one must embrace the darkness. And so lies our only hope.
Lovely pin drop there, that was really nice.
This is a very impressive CG trailer altogether.
Yeah, so it's a lovely CG trailer. I have no idea what the fuck this is though.
I was wondering if it was that Witchfire thing, but I don't think
No.
It's not Diablo, right?
No.
It doesn't feel like it.
So it's like a Souls-like or something.
But he said we've been waiting on it, so...
Yeah, I know. I get the sense that a lot of people listening to this right now are probably like, is this, you idiots? And I'm just like, I don't know what this is.
Great character models and stuff.
Oh yeah, it looks great.
Great designs.
Yeah.
That lantern's playing up a lot of business here.
Yeah, it certainly is. It certainly is. Have you been straight murdered? That's a fantastic CG trailer. You think that's UEFI as well?
I don't know, yeah.
The Lords of the Fallen.
The Lords of the Fallen, indeed. They did say Lords of the Fallen a few times within that, and I was like, I wonder if that's like the tagline to whatever we're going to see here, but it's actually just the name of the game.
That's right. They dropped the two. The Lords of the Fallen. Alright, now it's time for another new game announcement. The sequel to
a game. Lords of the Fallen, a game I should know about this.
I think the first one, I can see it in my head, but I didn't know anyone was particularly excited about it.
No, great trailer though.
Yeah.
Missing your regular FARTs? Have you tried going online? Visit Exotic Destinations.
Smooth Moves is a fantastic name for a removal company.
This is such a sort of change of pace from that previous trailer.
It really is. It really is.
From sort of heavy fantasy death metal to fart gags.
This just looks like moving out, right?
Yeah, very much so. But with a maybe more of a moving in, building your house type vibe.
Oh, I see. Yeah, I get you. I get you.
You can do it. Move locally or connect together online. Nice one. Coming 2023.
Oh, it's moving out. There you go.
Slightly different style, I thought, to the first one, but...
Yeah, I get what you mean. Like, there was a bit more of a sort of Animal Crossing vibe to going on to, you know what I mean?
Oh, here we are. Hogwarts.
Yes, it's time to step into the Potterverse. You guys excited for Hogwarts Legacy?
Not especially, Geoff.
It's coming out in February of 2023, and tonight at Gamescom, we've got
the
brand new trailer for you to take a look at. I don't want to say much and spoil much. This is an incredible trailer. I hope you enjoy it.
I've got to say, right, I'm not excited for this game. I'm never going to play this game, right? But every single time I see a trailer, I think that it looks better than it ought to.
That's how prepared we'll be. If either of you uses dark magic, I will notify the headmaster immediately.
Grass.
Curses are so named for a reason.
A spell that could save your life shouldn't be unforgivable.
The dark arts seem harmless until it's too late.
None of us will be able to avoid dark magic forever.
What do we do now?
It's up to us. I can teach you Crucio, or I can cast it on you.
I'm ready.
Crucio!
You've made your choice.
Yes.
They need to stop keeping so many skeletons in the basement of that castle. And doors that need to be tortured for some reason.
Stairway of bones, indeed.
What have the two of you done?
You smirking there at Liv Dunn, but there, Lewis. I wonder why.
Yeah. An interesting choice of tagline. I yeah.
She's got nothing to do with it, we swear.
Yeah, just. You might as well just write that.
That Switch version's no coming out on the 10th. No chance.
It's going to be one of these streaming ones as well, surely.
Tales from the Borderlands. This is cool.
The founder of Gearbox Entertainment Company, Randy Pitchford. Randy, great to see you here.
Oh, big Randy. Big Randy.
These guys probably know me from my work at Gearbox creating Borderlands. Any Borderlands fans in the house? Well, I got good news. I know some of you hardcore folks saw the leak, but I'm here to officially announce new Tales from the Borderlands.
Nope. Tell us about this. We remember Tales from the Borderlands. This is new Tales from Borderlands. This is new characters, new story.
It is. You know, I loved the original game, and so that's why we got some of the original storytellers and writers that were back in the day at Telltale and developed an all-new storyline with all new characters created with production from Gearbox Studio Quebec. It's an all-new experience, and we're
that's
here to show it for the first time today.
Strong trouser choice there from Randy, I've got to say.
Let's do it. It's coming soon, too, right?
That's right. Coming in October of this year. October of this year, all platforms.
Awesome. Well, let's take a look.
Good that some of those Telltale devs landed on this and, you know, got to continue with this. Because the first game was really beloved, right?
Yeah, no, it was. I never played it, but I was always one of the Telltale games I wanted to get around of and sort of never did, you know? I guess this is just done by Gearbox, though, not by Telltale at all, like new Telltale.
Yeah, not new Telltale, no, it just seems to be brought in house.
We are in the middle of a TDR invasion.
Leave immediately! This area is now under TDR jurisdiction!
They think there was a vault key being kept on the station.
If we can find whatever's in that vault before TDR does, we can change our lives!
We're bad at this, like really bad.
Tidio has many guns, talking guns, guns with legs.
I'm gonna blast you so freaking fast. Shut up, Richard.
Definitely still Borderlands.
Yeah. I mean, right, think what you want about Borderlands and the quality of its writing and specifically jokes, but it has such style about it, this game, I think. Like, it really does. Are they sort of implying here, perhaps, that it's slightly more than just dialogue choices and a story? Like, there seems to be a lot of action in that trailer, you know?
I don't know.
And no dialogue options.
Yeah, well, they're perhaps not showing that off yet.
No, I get it.
They're just, don't worry about them.
I mean, maybe they are evolving it a wee bit, but surely it's going to cling pretty tightly to what the first one was kind of doing at its core.
Techland, this will be Dying Light, yeah?
Dying Light, yeah.
That survived millennia. Homo
Neanderthalensis. This DLC, I'm guessing.
Homo Rhodesiensis. Homo Erectus. All of them wiped out by the deadliest species of all. Us. I am Astrid. This is the new arena. And my advice for you? Stay alive.
Is this Dying Light Battle Royale, Lewis?
Oh, don't say that. I mean, it looks like a different vibe from the base game to me, but...
It really does, yeah. You fight
for glory. Although, not that I know where that game ended up, obviously, but...
Anyone can be a warrior. What makes you different is the spirit of a champion.
Let out the beast. Let out the beast.
Bloody ties.
Coming very soon as well.
He does.
Red Bull gives you wings.
That's a lazy advert from Red Bull there.
Wasn't a great advert, was it? You want to join me?
These are just ads, right? This is just an ad list.
Yeah. It's a Keighley showcase. They all have ads on them. Yeah, this is, I dare say, something not terribly worth paying attention to. Unless this is Skull and Bones, that'd be a fucking hell of a turnaround. It's not.
No, it's not. Not yet rated.
Are these just ads? These are just ads, right?
Yeah, it's just the sort of sizzle reels that these publishers will be buying up to put into the show. Because we're not getting anything from Keighley here to say world premieres or whatever, so...
Yeah, this is just...
Although, like, you'd think a Team 17...
Take a look at this. Could... That's what I was thinking. Yeah. I saw Team 17 there and I was thinking, oh, well. This looks like... But that should have been more notable.
Is this a Warhammer or something? It has that kind of vibe about it.
No, this is too... Techie for Warhammer,
I thought there was a kind of, yeah, there's a Space Marines version of the Warhammer stuff, I think, but
yeah, I know, but it's just a bit too neon. That's sort of what I was getting at. Like that guy.
Yeah. Let them come and see. Guy with smoke for head.
I like those two guys. Those two guys are awesome. The rest of this is doing very little for me.
Not my kind of thing at all, but a fun enough little trailer for it, whatever it is. I love this guy with smoke for a head. Middle dude's got a sort of scorpion style spear into that. Lightfall. Oh, it's Destiny 2!
Oh, it's Destiny 2! I think
different.
This was announced
earlier today.
Then, this Saturday, the Gamescom Awards will be handed out to the winners of the best games on the show floor. Only submitted games showing at Gamescom will be eligible to be nominated, and the awards will be streamed on all Gamescom channels, so make sure to tune in. But tonight, I'm allowed to hand out 4 awards. I'm very, very excited about that. And I would say, let's jump straight into it, starting with the most wanted PC game. Here are your nominees.
This will be interesting. I can see why this is 2 hours long now.
I don't remember this from last
Metal Hellsinger, though.
Yeah.
I thought System Shock was sort of Warhammer gone or dead. Darktide. Or is that a remake?
I'm not sure, to be honest.
And
that's it. There's only 3 PC games.
Oh, that's it. Just the 3. To be fair, Metal Hellsinger is sort of wild as a game concept. Yeah. I kind of like it. I'm just not sure how much it will translate to actually being a good game.
I mean, I think a few people have played the Early Access and stuff and really enjoyed it.
Oh, but, yeah.
But, I mean, to me, it's, you know, it's got shooting, which I'm not particularly bothered about. And it's got metal music, which I am not especially interested in either. But I really thought it would be up your street. I would be surprised if you didn't give this a shot and like it at some point, just because it looks to me like Doom with a soundtrack, basically. A different soundtrack.
Yeah.
Bit more of a kind of rhythm game element to it, maybe, but...
Well, yeah, I mean, that is it. I mean, they're bumping up the sort of rhythm game element of Doom.
Kindness and empathy, just as much as any other craft in games, would be the key to successful game development. And it's precisely those qualities that my team possess and why I'm so privileged to be working with them every day. I love you guys at home. I miss you so much. So what I want to say to you, my industry friends and colleagues, is treat each other with
heart, kindness, and respect every day. Make games with humanity. Thank you so much. Congratulations once again.
Good for her.
Yeah,
nice wee message there. Yeah.
Back to you.
Thank you, Melly. Well,
I thought we were getting more awards there, but I guess not. Going.
It's time to move to the world of Sonic. Any Sonic Hedgehog fans out there?
Oh, Christ.
Sonic has had a pretty good year with the Sonic 2 movie, which was a ton of fun earlier this year. Well, Sonic Frontiers is in development.
Then it all came crashing back down, didn't it, Jeff?
Of the release date, too. Check this out.
Ah, release
date. That's a release date. Good call, Lewis.
Wow. I mean, they've told us absolutely everything else about this.
Well, that is true. That is very true.
Several times over.
Can I just say, and I maintain this, in concept, this is a good idea for Sonic.
I still think it's looking...
And execution seems poor.
I don't know. I still think there's elements of its execution that I think people are being overly critical about. But from all accounts from people who've played it, including like big Sonic fans, they're saying it should. It looks and feels like it should be delayed a bit to get it right. And I can't see why they wouldn't do that, you know? I mean, it's got fast running. It's got Green Hill Zone.
Yeah, obviously.
Else do you need?
Obviously. Like, there's no reason. There is no reason this couldn't be a good game.
Yeah, I don't
like
see
a really
why,
good game. Actually, like this could have reinvented Sonic.
Yeah.
And I'm just not sure that they have done that.
I mean, I'm totally willing to see what the kind of reaction is like when it actually drops. Because
I feel just like a lot so of people have just when seen, people got their hands on
like
it. Though
some of the initial stuff that we saw looked ropey, but some people had hands on and were saying there's definitely good qualities to it. It just needs tuned up, you know. The combat seemed to be one thing that was kind of lacking, but I don't know. Like you say, in concept and theory, it should be decent, I think, at worst.
Let's hope so.
November 8th.
Oh, wow, that is sooner than I thought it was going to be.
Yeah, this is it. Like, they won't move out this year for some reason, even though year, a lot of people seem to think it should be.
Another European studio wanted to use Gamescom ONL as a platform to announce another narrative experience. This comes from a French studio. Check this out.
Oh, Quantic Dream indeed.
We leave so many things.
And it's not Star Wars.
Objects. Memories. Mistakes. They sink in time. Touch the bottom and go to sleep. Silence is full. And here, voices can only come from the deep. Deep under the waves.
Under the waves.
Next year. Nice little trailer that I've got to say. Like, it looks like a nice world. Underwater stuff usually awful,
guys.
Right enough.
Very true.
It's time for the goats. Ready for some goats? No live goats today, but we are here to talk about Goat Simulator 3. We got to announce this back at Summer Game Fest. And now it's time to see the gameplay of Goat Simulator 3.
It is wild
time.
To me
Let's
how popular these games
out.
Are.
That's crazy, isn't it?
I mean, fair enough. Like, they look like the definition of dumb fun.
Yeah.
But yeah, I mean, fair enough. This is... going to be wild because it's a goat simulator.
Yeah. it's just the truest expression of like a physics-y sandbox game, isn't it? It's just like anything goes, total chaos.
I mean, it does look fun.
I feel like it would be fun for about 10 minutes and then you'd just be like, oh, nah, that'll do. You know?
That goat was a pig.
Special. Zen goat.
I mean, it is batshitting, not really.
Yeah, like, if you'd never heard of this before, what on earth are you supposed to make of this? I guess that's
that
all
joust, that was amazing. They just flopped right out of the original. Fair enough.
November 17th, that has literally about everything you could imagine in it. Goat Simulator 3, all right. A lot of people ask me how I got started in the industry, and what I loved doing when I was a kid with my brother, we would play PC adventure games, and I grew up playing classic LucasArts adventure games.
Certainly will be. Yep.
By chance? Well, I am so excited because there is a new Monkey Island in development right now. Ron Gilbert, the series creator, is back. You may have heard about it. Return to Monkey Island, and tonight at Gamescom, I am so excited that we get to announce the release date, or actually, I don't. We get to go to Stan to tell us the release date. Check this out.
Hello, friends. It's your old pal Stan, coming to you through the magic of marketing to let you know that your search for quality entertainment is about to bear fruit. But I wouldn't be doing my job if I just dropped the details on you.
Interesting arm situation we're having on here. See the kind of fine dining establishments you'll be visiting. Because I was going to say, the hate that this game was getting for its art style was absolutely ridiculous. And it, the actual game, I still think, looks really great and really stylish and really cool. This dude does not.
I mean, that's part of the gag, I suspect.
Return to Monkey Island launches September 19th, which happens
September 19th? God, that is very close. Like a pirate
day. That is very close. You can order it. Is that true? Is it on National Public Pirate Day? That'd be great.
I don't know, yeah.
A pre-order. As a bonus, I'm ready to unload this shipment of beautiful horse armor to anyone who pre-orders Return to Monkey Island. It'll look fantastic in your inventory.
Oi, you missed a spot.
I've got to go now. I've got a lot of irons and a lot of fires. You know how it is. But I'll be back to steal every scene I'm in Return to Monkey Island. I'll see you there. All pre-order customers will receive the exclusive horse armor item in their inventory. Please note that the horse armor has no practical use in-game and in no way will contribute to the gameplay, puzzles, or narrative of Return to Monkey Island.
I was going to say, is there even horses in this game?
Oh my God. That was good. That was good.
I love the horse armor. It does absolutely nothing. It just sits in your inventory. Return to Monkey Island. Cannot wait for that. All right. Now, let's turn to the world of Unknown Worlds, the creators of Subnautica. As we've teased, they are here today at Gamescom to unveil a brand new IP, and it's a departure from Subnautica. It's a brand new turn-based sci-fi game, and we're going to reveal it for the first time.
That's up my street list. He said all the good ones.
Hi, I'm Brandon Sanderson. You might know me as the author of the Mistborn series.
I do know him. Archive, also, that podcast we had on it not that long ago.
Robert Jordan's Wheel of Time. Over the last few years, I've been working closely with my friends at Unknown Worlds on the exciting project we're revealing today. You, of course, know Unknown Worlds for creating immersive and fantastical worlds like the incredible Subnautica series. When they reached out to me, I was absolutely thrilled to help craft the expansive sci-fi universe in which their next game is set. This secret has been a hard one to keep, and we're so excited to finally show you what we've created together. So, without further ado,
this feels like this Miyazaki and R.R. Martin on a much smaller scale, unfortunately.
I think we'd be very glad of that comparison.
Actually, has a bit of a Borderlands vibe about it.
Welcome to the party.
Well, Lewis, this was like not what I was expecting. Yeah. That is literal action figures.
This'll be over real quick.
With even that sort of movement of it.
Yeah.
Ooh. Can't say this is doing much.
An interesting choice.
Why would they do it like this?
They'll never see this coming.
I mean, in reality, this is your sort of game, and actually a lot of the games I've been playing recently have been in this very genre as well. And they've made it look very static by making all their characters not move.
I mean, yeah, gameplay itself looks, you know, pretty standard for a game like this, but they're just the style of it immediately is not doing a hell of a lot for me. Oh, can you kind of build your own? Oh, no, it's just building your own team. I thought they were going to, like, build your own figures, which would maybe be... So they're going for a tabletop vibe, right? Like the,
yeah, totally. Yeah. Okay, right.
Like, really in-depth tabletop vibe. Which, I'm sure there'll be people out there who'll be into that, but, yeah.
Yeah, this is, like, what... Warhammer, yeah, right? Like tabletop Warhammer.
Yeah. But then I get, like, unless you've not got the kind of skill or ability to paint the figurines yourself, I'm not sure why you wouldn't just be playing a tabletop version, but...
Yeah, I mean, video game is a good part about them is that everything doesn't have to be static. Moonbreaker.
Right. Early access September 29th.
And joining me from Unknown Worlds is Charlie Cleaver.
I hope that's good.
So different than Subnautica. So
yes, it is.
This departure, you guys like to kind of reinvent yourselves every game, right?
Yeah, so people thought we were kind of crazy for making Subnautica after making Natural Selection. We went from a strategy shooter to a pacifist underwater game, survival. So I feel like we've done this before. We love changing genres. But I'm hoping, you know, our Subnautica fans will still come along for playing a digital miniatures game. I hope.
Well, it's so cool. A digital miniatures game.
A digital miniatures game is a good way to describe that. It makes it sound better than that trailer.
Guardians of the Galaxy or Firefly kind of feel. So you can see that from the colorful art style we have. So you choose a captain and 10 crew, and you build a roster, kind of like a traditional miniatures game. And every unit in the game is really... like strange and special and kind of game breaking. So you deploy units and you move them around on the battlefield and you get all these crazy game changing powers, kind of like Hearthstone meets XCOM, kind of.
Well, you see the gameplay here, it looks great and
interesting.
Soon, as we said, in the September, so you're not early.
This guy's doing a better job at selling it to me.
Wow, see, easy to name games you want to be compared to.
Yeah, I guess.
Painting was cathartic for you sort of during the pandemic, right?
Yeah, so the painting, I mean, you can't have a miniatures game without painting, and during the lockdown...
I do think this is quite a nice touch.
I agree. Yeah, I think that's probably the
really relaxed
most interesting part of it in a lot of ways, to be honest.
Around us. And we really tried to capture that feeling. It's not like Photoshop or like special technical tools or anything like that. We just simulate washes, dry brushing, we've got decals. This feels like you're actually painting a real miniature. And I have to say, because everyone is surprised by it, like all the miniatures you see painted in the game are all painted with the tool. Wow. So it's like actually pretty powerful.
Amazing. Well, it's so cool that you were...
I mean, that does sound cool, but also if you have to do that level of detail and everything, when do you actually play the game?
I would have thought that that would be optional. Like, I'm sure that you could just choose a color for various areas of them. You know what I mean? To make them look off decent, you know?
Open weekends, and then we're going to be launching into Steam Early Access September 29th. So it's really close.
Only a month away, Moonbreaker. Charlie, thank you so much for coming all the way out here.
Thank you.
I know you had a tough time.
My pleasure.
Here,
thank you, everyone.
All right, Charlie Cleveland with Unknown Worlds. Thank you so much, Charlie. And now it's time to reveal another game with a very catchy tune in the trailer. Check this out.
Let me tell you about the friends that invested all they had on a shady site that looked like a scam. It said buy this magic card to play the coolest game and fight against your friends with no consequence.
Interesting.
What do you think? Some kind of deck builder?
It's
got to
be,
right?
Got to be. Although, I don't know, it's also setting up to be an FPS, question mark? No, I guess it must be. It must be some sort of... Friends versus Friends. Oh, here we go. That's an FPS.
it looks a lot like... that's the basis of Neon White. Right?
I was going to say, I can summon the name of the game there. Yeah, Neon White, yeah.
But, like, Neon White is all about pace and movement, whereas that looks more like a sort of standard shooter.
Story of Pinocchio, Lies of P is a new action Souls-like game that is coming out from NeoWiz, and you guide Pinocchio on his unrelenting journey to become human. This game looks absolutely great, and we've got a brand new gameplay trailer to show you.
See, stuff like this is so cool. It's like that Winnie the Pooh horror thing.
Yeah,
it's coming to Games Pass. That's cool. It's like that Winnie the Pooh horror thing. See, when copyright isn't a thing, people can do really, really fucking creative and different things with IP, and it would be great if more of that could happen, Disney. They're really going for the creepy vibe in this, man.
Oh, they definitely are.
Yeah. I'm so here for it. This is a cracking idea for a game.
Such a Bloodborne vibe about it from what
Yeah, sure, definitely. Yeah, yeah. I might be
asking too much of you. Kind of steampunk Bloodborne.
But I don't have a choice. But also how it's Pinocchio.
Yeah, somehow it's Pinocchio, yeah.
I'm anticipating something much more on the scale of like a Plague's Tale or something here, though.
Yeah.
But I mean, although, does look very good for that scale of game.
I mean, if it is, how do you do a Souls-like at that scale? That's the only thing, you know.
Oh, I mean, there've been loads of Souls-like games that have come out in that sort of scale. You know what I mean? That aren't fucking Elden Ring epics. Yeah. You know what I mean? Another talking lamp. Or another lamp talk. I don't think it did. It was just also glowy and blue. That's a very Souls-esque health bar up the top there as well. And weapon selection and everything. Man, I mean,
yeah,
it looks all right. It looks all right.
Yeah, you've got to get that feel right for a game like this. But, you know, interesting monster design, worlds look interesting. Yeah.
It's just a really interesting concept, I think. It would just be really great if this was good. Your destiny. I'm here for that, man. I think it looks great. I think it looks good.
Coming next year, and yeah, coming to Game Pass. So they said.
Feels like a Game Pass game as well, I've got to say. Like that sort of scale, you know.
Yes, you.
More adverts.
Fear of missing Gamescom. Relax. Gamescom is everywhere you want.
Is this an ad for Gamescom at Gamescom?
Yep, it does seem to be.
That's right. All the fun of Gamescom is available from wherever you are online, obviously, and well, in case you're wondering who that little guy is, that's Appy, and he's on a mission to save the Gamescom verse
from the
evil future.
This little robot guy.
Oh, at the bottom, all right.
Check out the epic section at Gamescom.
Yep, a load of rubbish.
Like, he's just the mascot, right? Like, he's no one of consequence. Right? Like, it's not from a game or anything.
No, no.
Right.
It's just meant to look a bit like it would be.
With me. There is, for example, the Gamescom Studio by IGN featuring game spotlights, dev interviews, and all insights into this year's Gamescom. So please make sure to check that out so you don't miss anything.
I've got to say, like, I think it's quite good that Geoff Keighley's got like a co-host and whatever. I think that's quite cool, particularly someone who is German, I believe, and because it's been held in Germany. But she has got all the rubbish jobs, man. She's got all the shit.
Reading this stuff, no one wants to pay any attention to, really.
Is the cosplay
contest on Sunday, where the super creative cosplay community takes center stage, and this is absolutely one of my favorites, so make sure to not miss it out. It is definitely worth the
watch.
Was
that a wee sigh at the cosplay contest?
No, it wasn't the cosplay thing. It's just the weird, like, I was thinking there how this is, the hangover of trying to present online and in person, right, where this is essentially a pitch to people in the room currently about what you can go and do when you're at Gamescom. But we are watching it as part of this two-hour show when it's completely irrelevant to the vast majority of the online audience, right?
Is that an actual astronaut in space? That seems like a massive waste of her time. It feels very much as though she should have better things to do right now. The hair is cracking, man. That looks like something out of Dragon Ball Z, that's great.
They create curiosity, interest, and the love of space exploration in gamers around the world. As we look towards returning to the moon and onto Mars with our ambitious Terra Nova program, humanity's spaceflight capabilities will be in part thanks to the games industry. And who knows, perhaps even you will be among us here at ESA.
It feels as though the games industry will have a very small hand to play in that.
Real world impacts that lead us all closer to the stars. So on behalf of everyone at ESA, bravo. Keep creating, keep innovating, and keep playing. This is ESA astronaut Samantha Cristoforetti wishing everyone a wonderful Gamescom from the International Space Station.
And a wee somersault for the cameras. Very good.
Otherwise, we couldn't have known she was in space.
No, couldn't have done. Couldn't have done.
Yeah. Okay, sure.
World premiere, though, Liz. Yeah. World premiere.
This is going for a heavy Star Wars vibe so far.
Yes, yes it is. It's going to be a sieve type situation, do we think?
I imagine so. Or a sort of survival sim.
Yeah.
Stranded Alien Dawn.
Interesting.
It's in October, yeah. I mean, it looks very unfinished at the moment, so don't want to say too much on that.
We're looking at games for Gamescom Opening Night Live. One of the things that was most impressive this year is there are a lot of European studios that want to debut games here, and also a lot of brand new IP, brand new worlds, and we're going to introduce one of those to you right now, and I think you're going to get pretty excited about it. Check out this world premiere.
The sand has memories. Memories of our past, when gods walked this world, and our heroes stood amongst them. But the gods' vanity grew, and in their struggle, we were cast away.
This looks like Forsakenless. Like a lot like it.
In the ruins of this shattered...
It's not though, right?
No, it's not.
But you're right, it does look quite a lot like Forspoken.
Oh, Forspoken. I think I said Forsaken the first time. Again, this is looking quite UE5 as well to me, all this. I think that it has a specific sort of lighting to it, I'm noticing.
Is this just Dune but set thousands of years ago? We've got sand, we've got stuff moving under the sand. You got some kind of sand dogs now?
Sand dogs!
Oh, God.
Sand dogs have been scalped. Oh, Christ, the sand dogs were bigger than that initial shot. Yeah. It made me believe them to be.
I also thought this guy was the bad guy, but clearly not. Or at least seems to be fighting alongside us.
Yeah, he was getting sort of bad guy code in that guy,
yeah,
wasn't he, right?
Yeah, definitely, yeah. Maybe sand dogs are worse than
that dude.
People.
Even in ruins, we endure. We won't let go. For now, we can stand for ourselves.
Mega Sand Dog.
And face gods.
Atlas Fallen, eh? Nope, oh, better gameplay there.
Looks like a DMC style combat sort of situation
there.
Yeah.
Not bad. Could be terrible, but not too bad.
Any game could be terrible. Liz. It could be good, is what you should be saying.
Late 90s is Homeworld. Anyone else play that back in the day? Great PC space RTS. Well, a brand new Homeworld is coming out next year, and we've got a brand new look at some new gameplay.
I can't say I've ever heard of Homeworld, if I'm completely honest.
It's not ringing about me, you know?
I don't know, it feels as if we've both got any RTSs and perimeter scan.
I mean, even in recent times. Just the major ones. Like,
oh, this is... No, this is an RTS on a scale I'm not comfortable with.
Fighters were no problem, but the missile frigates were a different story. Command got clever. One wing used cover to keep themselves safe on approach. Target acquired. While another group found a tunnel in the structure to sneak behind them. We're on the right target with range.
Teach them up. Let's go. I mean, it looks visually very cool.
Yeah, but what the fuck is going on?
Ships in that fighting.
There's just stuff appearing and moving. Like, nothing much seems to be happening very much. We're attacking capital ships.
Protected the resources while they hauled in the goods, which meant we could roll out assault frigates.
Cleared hot. Let's take it to them. Stay on them. Break contact.
The raiders weren't pushovers, but command.
It's like space command and conquer, right?
Yeah, it does look like that.
The way their carrier exploded. Beautiful. And we even grabbed a little souvenir. That missile frigate is ours now.
Homeworld 3.
Launches first half 2023.
Homeworld 3 in the first half of 2023.
Well, now today not doing a hell of a lot for me that, but if people have been genuinely excited about the previous ones, then fair enough. Impact,
which is an incredible here we go.
From Hoyoverse. Well, today we've got an exclusive new look at version 3.0 in the new Rainforest Nation, as well as a sneak peek.
I'm sure a lot of people will be incredibly excited about this, but this will be of absolutely zero interest in their buzz list.
Thank you.
certainly looks like Genshin Impact.
I mean, it's denying it's a pretty
almost,
game, but,
almost yeah. nothing to say about this. Yeah, I mean, it does. Yeah, it looks good. It looks good for what it is, do you know what I mean?
I mean, and people fucking love it and are spending a hell of a lot of money in it as well.
Yeah, I think that's critical to its success. Yeah,
what makes me not want to go anywhere near it.
I mean, to me, this isn't showing anything remotely new, but I mean, I'm just so unfamiliar with the game, I would never know.
Yeah, absolutely no idea. What did he say they were getting a sneak look at some new area or something? But yeah, it's just been going on so long now, I have absolutely no idea what's happening with it.
Version 3 said, or
yeah,
whatever, so.
I know, yeah. Oh, yeah, some sort of Egypt zone we got.
Right, okay. Okay, there you go. Stereotypical Egypt zone. There you have it.
I mean, that's just an advert, isn't it? That's just an advert
basically,
for a game that's already
basically.
Out.
What an absolutely beautiful game, and that's not all from Hoyoverse, because they also have Honkai Star Rail in development. It's a grand interstellar adventure with strategic turn-based combat, and now we're going to take a new look at the story and adventure that awaits you in Honkai Star Rail.
I think we've seen this before as well. I think it could even have been at Summer Game Fest.
Oh, yeah?
I think so, yeah. Although, having said that, I'm not recognizing
this. I don't remember
this.
Space Train very much. I feel like maybe we were just told they were developing new stuff, but...
Maybe. I'm sure I've seen other games that they have in development. I assumed it was this one, but maybe I was wrong about that. Maybe they have other games in development. You are not one of them, Jin-Yuan. They do have a very specific style to them, which is like cel-shaded anime.
Yeah. Which, you know, I suspect a lot of people out there are totally on board with it.
Yeah, man. I mean, I don't think it looks bad. I don't think these games like visually look bad at all.
The Senjo is in danger. This man, he...
The train is about to make the jump. Hold on, everyone.
Space Train, by the way. I'm sorry here for Space Train, I've got to say.
No rail, but they still made it look like a train.
Hello.
Yeah.
It is not yeah. Time
can't be the smartest option.
They also called it Star Rail.
Most wanted Microsoft Xbox game.
Most wanted Xbox game. I mean, this has absolutely got to be Starfield. Any of them.
The Last Case of Benedict Fox.
That does look class, by the way. I was well into that one we saw.
Metal Hellsinger again.
Oh, is this for games that are shown at the show?
Must be, yeah.
The Last Case of Benedict Fox.
Ah, fair enough.
Fair enough, man. I think that game does look class.
And notice, though, that Penitent, which we know is there, was not included.
Is that definitely going to be there?
That's what Xbox said, yeah. Whether it's just that it's available
on
the show floor.
Yeah. Yeah. I think that does say probably quite a lot about that game, unfortunately, Liz.
Support and Rogue Team for being the best publisher ever, and especially I would like to thank my team in Krakow. They are crazy talented, and my hands hold the award, but their hands make the game. Dziękuję wam bardzo. Thank you.
Congratulations once again, The Last Case of Benedict Fox. And Geoff?
That game does look great. Presumably that's company Game Pass.
Ah, yeah.
Game Pass, Game Pass. I'm trying not to say it.
Justin Roiland.
Plural. Sorry.
Well,
yeah.
He's got a brand new game, which you may have seen at Xbox's show in June, called High on Life. It is coming to Xbox and Game Pass in December. And
I think they just announced this was
just
delayed as well.
You're going to enjoy through this, the week, though. Talking guns in a boss fight, and that's all I'm going to say to set this up. I think you're going to really. This is a trip. Check this out. World premiere of High on Life.
Squanch Games.
Hey,
I can't not hear Morty anytime he does a voice.
Come on, admit it. We're hurting you. No, fuck you. Are you even a real bounty hunter? Jesus, it's so gross you even went in there.
For a boss fight, this looks quite basic so far.
I mean, it does. I will be honest with you, it does.
I mean, obviously, the world and the ideas here and the character designs and gun designs.
Yeah.
Kind of doing the legwork, but it does need to be slightly more exciting as a game than we're getting so far.
Yeah. I assume.
I'll cut their fucking asshole off and eat it.
You know, this sludge matches your toxic personality.
Fuck off. That wasn't even a good one. Surprise, flesh bag.
I don't know, man.
Like, I just worry that
I'm sort of fearful.
If its main thing is like the Morty voice wisecracking. That could get very tiresome after a while, but hopefully it
is. I'm also assuming that this is a pretty early
like
boss
tutorial
fight.
Almost.
You know what I mean? Yeah.
Yeah.
Because like, I don't think your knife's going to be explaining his mechanics to you.
Yeah.
Late game, you know what I mean? Or certainly fucking hope not. To be honest with you, I think that this boss fight might exist to show you how to use that sort of like grapple mechanic might be its actual purpose.
If I'm going out, I'm taking you with me. Just stay alive. I think she's basically done for.
I mean, I think I'm sort of fine with this. You seem far more skeptical about it than me.
I thought that looked pretty awful as gameplay, to be honest. Like, quite boring, but the world and all that is definitely worth keeping an eye on.
Do
but
you see that?
I mean, seriously, if you had that fight in a game that's not just a tutorial, you'd be pretty disappointed, I think.
I mean, yeah, I guess. Yeah, I mean, it wasn't the greatest boss fight in the world. I'm not going to be here claiming that, but yeah.
Don't eat that. Come on, dude.
You know she's going to eat it.
What?
Very, very strange.
Told ya.
Ad as well. Don't even really know what that was.
What that was about, no.
This is a game that I thought might actually have been there in a more sensible capacity than just an ad. As in Warhammer.
Yeah.
Is this just a sort of.
Systems to be an ad, really.
Sizzle reel.
Yeah. Whether it's all the same, all the same publisher, maybe.
Well, Hellslinger seems to have been in development for fucking...
I know, I thought it was out already.
Well, I think that's because it's been in early access for forever.
The Rising, that's had a bit of a year. People seem to really flock to that.
Yeah?
Yeah, it's one of these games that, particularly on PC, that just seem to kick off, you know? Some kind of giant sand guy in PUBG now as well, is that right?
Standard. I mean, Goku's in Fortnite.
God, Fortnite.
You can't really
insane,
say
isn't?
Anything about that, yeah.
You've been selected from among thousands of candidates.
Hey, Cutter.
To join the Lynx family.
You're from Earth, right?
This is more than just a job. It's
an opportunity.
You ever miss it?
Caution.
Oh, shit.
Lynx, making the world
a better place.
Why
What they say about work in space is true.
There's something real special.
We've
here.
Seen this before as well, I'm sure.
You don't have power
somewhere.
Here.
Yeah, I'm not sure.
Yeah.
I remember like an FPS like this, but not a sort of whatever this is, a sort of survival.
Maybe I'm misremembering then. Yeah. This is looking very familiar to me, I'm not gonna lie. Even when they were saying links there, I was like, yeah, that's ringing the bell as well. I don't know if it's, I don't know what it's called, but
the most important game we'll play this year.
I mean,
Hard Space Shipbreaker.
Oh, this is already out.
I think next month it's out there. Yeah.
I'm sure if
it seemed to have a lot of good reviews for something that I'm not really aware of, but
I've definitely
that was it coming to consoles or something, and that it's on PC at the moment, or
oh, this is a
Game Pass
PC yeah. Game Pass section, it looks like. Which means that this could very well end with Death Stranding.
Of course, yeah.
Which in a lot of ways is a bananas announcement that is a real thing.
Yeah, it's quite strange, isn't it? It feels like a bit of a workaround of Sony there. But Immortality coming to PC Game Pass. Can't wait for that.
Is that...
That's the new Sam Barlow.
Sam Barlow, yeah, Sam Barlow.
Which is coming out like next week.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
High on Life going to be on Game Pass as well. That is...
Yeah.
Definitely where that will be getting played. I mean, I've seen worse sizzle reels, I've got to say. A lot of this is like things I'm like, yep, a lot of which people will be interested in this. Interesting that they just seem to be highlighting the PC side of it, you know?
Yeah, it feels like they've been pushing that quite hard recently for reasons slightly unknown to me, but yeah. Maybe they'll just do another.
I hope they get on Steam Deck, man. That'd be awesome. Project is based on the Prime Video series The Expanse.
Well, we showed you a little bit of the trailer at the Game Awards to set up the world. Now you're going to get a first glimpse at the gameplay with this behind-the-scenes clip. Enjoy.
You ever watch this show?
Lewis, I'd never even heard of the show.
Yeah. It's great, Mick.
Shows you how much TV I watch these days. We'll see what we can do.
Captain Drummer, what are your orders?
The Expanse is obviously one of those universes that has a ton of opportunity to tell great stories.
Have you watched this? Is this like a thing you're into?
No, I watched like the first episode of it and it wasn't doing much for me. But I know people, particularly friends who are into Star Trek, that liked it.
Oh wait, Deck Nine are involved in this?
Yeah.
Oh, that's interesting. That's made me 1,000 times more interested in this suddenly. Engaging
in something rather than just being a passive audience member.
You'll figure something out. I know you will.
It's actually been a really interesting thing as an actor to explore some of her more vulnerable sides that by the time we meet her in the series, they've been cauterized.
Because this score drummer, this is the greatest score any scavenger has ever come across. You'll need me if you...
Graphics are still looking quite telltale.
Yeah.
I'm glad to say. Not that things should be... judged on their graphics too harshly, I would say.
No.
Exploded ship that now constitutes several parts in a mass that you can move them on. And balancing that out against almost like you're excavating a story. That's
I'm glad Deck Nine are involved in this because this does look a lot more Life is Strange than it does a traditional Telltale game.
Totally,
game,
yeah.
Say,
which
yeah.
is the evolution that their stuff sort of needed.
Oh, definitely, definitely.
We're really excited about how it feels to both play and experience the story in the game.
Whoever did this is long gone, and we still have a ship that's ready to be scavenged. So get to it.
What is the vibe of the like show? Is it like a sort of horror thing? Then?
No, not in my eyes, but again, I never watched
more like traditional
of it.
Sci-fi.
Yeah,
or
I thought it was like very much like a kind of Star Trek-y thing, maybe with a slightly
Speaking
more serious spin. You know, like
another,
the modern Star Trek films or whatever.
Film
sure.
Adaptation that
into a game, which I don't think you would have ever expected. Check this out.
A film adaptation into a game.
Mm. That we're not expecting.
Interesting. I was going to say that was giving me Friday the 13th vibes in the beginning, then it yeah. went totally off the rails.
Oh, is it? Oh, no.
Not Friday the 13th. Fucking
Killer Clowns from Outer Space.
But that is incredible. Halloween is what I meant, by the way. Yeah, yeah. But what I didn't think it was going to be was, where the fuck is this?
Yeah, this isn't anything I'm aware of, but Kelly Clowns from Outer Space to the game. There you go.
Goats, Killer Clowns, we got it all tonight at Opening Night Live. Now we've got another brand new game announcement from a European publisher for a sci-fi action adventure. Here we go.
I think he feels the need to keep on pointing out all the European ones because he's in Europe.
Yeah, he has said it a few times.
Yeah, it's totally unnecessary. It's good, man. It's all good. Oh, Prime Mar. Why do I know that name? Explored, but found nothing.
Until now. It has been 6 months since the alien object known as the Metahedron suddenly appeared above Earth's atmosphere.
Personal log. Sentient contact assessment and response team.
Kate, we have an issue.
What happened?
Power supply failing.
Sensors offline.
I'm switching to backup generators.
Pretty atmospheric looking. I'm going to say the world's looking pretty.
Yep.
Pretty cool. Reminiscent of Returnal?
Yeah, Returnal is exactly what I was thinking of there. Scars above.
Scars above.
Coming soon.
Are you laughing at Scars Above?
I am slightly laughing at Scars Above.
Yeah, it feels like, they could have done better with the title, yeah, to be honest.
For like what looks like quite a serious game. In another version, it would have been quite a fun name, I think. But,
yeah. Yeah, it does feel as though the game's taking itself a bit too seriously
for a kind of
for our name like that. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You guys are part of that too. Now, as part of this initiative, Gamescom, along with the United Nations Environmental Program Initiative, Playing for the Planet, are going to give out the first ever Gamescom Goes Green Award to the best sustainability concept from an exhibitor here at Gamescom. And the nominees are Microsoft, Xbox, Yuki, and the Indie Arena booth. And to find out the winner, let's turn it over to Melly.
Thank you, Geoff. And yes, the winner of this year's Gamescom Goes Green Award is Yuki. And here to accept the award is Dr. Joe Twist, CEO of Yuki. Congratulations.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Gamescom, for this wonderful award. It's brilliant to be recognized. Thank you to the Yuki team who work so hard every day to be greener. And thank you to the UN's Playing for the Planet Alliance for inspiring us to change.
What is their idea? Can you just tell us that?
You know, it's yeah. so fantastic to see these amazing game worlds that we're going to
I mean, don't get me wrong, I like that
over the next year.
Things like this are being recognized, you know, particularly big showcases like this and whatever, but
to live on.
Yeah, and we only have what has actually been awarded here, you know?
And to protect that planet so that we can continue to play our games. So everybody, whether you're a player or a business, can make one small change starting tomorrow, and together we can play more games together and save the planet. Thank you very much. Thank you, Joe, and congratulations. But I won't share the secret. Remember, it is not only the organizers or exhibitors that can go green. All of you can also make a change by donating to the Gamescom Forest. So plant your Gamescom tree today. Geoff, back to you.
Awesome. Gamescom Forest, indeed. I didn't realize that was a literal forest either.
Now it's time to announce a brand new game from a new studio of industry veterans working on an ambitious new RPG. Here's the first tease.
New studios and ambition.
New studio, industry veteran, classic.
Yeah. Oh, shit. Right. That is some credentials right there, I've got to say. Something Wicked Games. I mean, to be fair, if a new studio was going to make an RPG, I would want it to be a studio full of people who worked on all those things.
One before the shadow, and one behind the eye.
Oh dear.
Well. Well, this is creepy and cool. And is that a D or an Olus?
I think it's a weird song.
Weird song. Right, I can see.
Interesting.
Not very interesting. Very interesting.
All right, let's talk about Xbox and Age of Empires 4 that continues to expand. Now we have news on the next civilizations joining the battle as free DLC. If you want to learn more about what's happening with Age of Empires 4, tune into the Xbox booth stream for developer interviews on Thursday. But right now, here's that announcement from Age of Empires 4.
There's more than one way to win a battle.
This game just has such legs. It's just one of these games that could just go on forever and ever and ever, and they just add new
stuff to it all the time.
Yeah, new stuff, new civilizations, new mechanics, and it would just work.
Whether you strike from afar or ambush up close, the Malians will use wit and strategy to outmaneuver their opponents and gain the advantage on the battlefield.
Feels as though all those dudes should have seen them.
With powerful siege tools and the ability to rally large formations, the Ottomans can keep the pressure on to bring down their enemies' defenses.
That feels like an empire that should have been in there. I mean, as far as empires go, that was probably quite a big one, I would have thought.
I don't know if there's some sort of, is there some sort of narrative within the game that maybe puts it at a certain point in time and then they'll just add later or earlier stuff to it? I have absolutely no idea either.
So I assume that there's some sort of campaign, but I don't think it would be anything like that. That would restrict them from doing stuff, And the Malians. Oh, well, there you go. If you enjoy Age of Empire, I'm sure that'll be exciting to you. And on Game Pass, of course.
Of course.
Here we go.
Excited for Gotham Knights?
Absolutely not.
Well, you don't have to wait long. It is coming this October, and Batgirl, Nightwing, Robin, and Red Hood are going to take over in Gotham Knights. You're probably wondering about the story. Who are the villains? Well, we've got a lot to share in this brand new trailer, and also some exciting news. The release date is going to be a little earlier than you expected. Check this out.
You're bringing the game forward. Now, that's interesting. That's something we don't often see. Jim Gordon. Probably for good reason. Also, if you've got the time, why would you not use it?
That's why I'm still here. And I've known for a while now that someday, like him, I'd have to work with you.
This is another one as well. Like, I think in concept, like, see a game like this about the Batman universe, but not about Batman, is a good idea. Like, that concept is a good one. I like that. I cannot help but feel that every single part of the gameplay here is just bad. Is Harley Quinn just going to be modelled on Margot Robbie for now until eternity now? Is that just
that's the thing as well with this. It doesn't feel like they've really visually distinguished it from the other games and from some of the other kind of DC stuff. that's been out over the last few years, which I can see why they would do it like that, and it's not a massive criticism.
Well,
but
I mean, it's not as if DC's been knocking them out of the park, you know what I mean?
No. But, you know, in kind of games terms, I suppose, like, the Batman stuff has gone well, and
well, not since Arkham, and that was a long time ago now, man.
Yeah, but that's all there is, isn't there?
Well, I'm sure there is other shit, but yeah.
Your skills. Your knowledge. Your adaptability. You got my back? Oh, boys!
Is this the one that's about the Court of Owls?
Yeah.
See, again, that was a cool idea as well.
Well, that's,
I like,
yeah,
that. That's a great idea.
That's, I was about to say before this trailer started, like, this is what we've been missing, I think, and what we've been waiting on is a bit of a look at, like, the rest of the world. Like, I feel like they've shown us so many trailers now that's like, here's a deep dive on Robin this time, you know?
Yeah, they also show this gameplay of this, like, I would say over a year ago, like comfortably, yeah, over a year ago, maybe 2 years ago, to be honest. And yeah, the game's just been delayed and delayed and delayed and delayed and delayed. It just felt as if they got out too early on this.
But, well, you say that, but then people have been demanding something from either Rocksteady or WWE Montreal for so long. So,
yeah.
For Gotham Knights. All right, now it's time.
When
to
did that? When was that due? Just a few weeks later.
The global announcement.
I honestly don't know.
It's a new adventure game developed by Everstone Games. It's called Where Winds Meet. It's an interactive open-world RPG featuring action, adventure, and martial arts set in a turbulent time in the Northern Song Dynasty. The combat looks really cool. Check out this announcement of Where Winds Meet.
Always a cool aesthetic, I think, sort of feudal Japan, isn't it? Sort of hard to go wrong with that.
Yeah.
God, they were some flammable curtains. Christ almighty. Straight up like that, I didn't even hesitate. That could have been cut straight from Ghost of Tsushima, that image. Looking a lot like Ghost of Tsushima.
Is he running on water? I was just about to say a minute
ago,
it looked
more
like he was just walking on
he
air.
He did look, yeah, as if he was walking on air. I was choosing not to bring that up, but he did look like that. I think mad jumps seem to be part of his game here. And walking on shit, he shouldn't be able to. I don't hate this.
No, it looks alright.
Don't hate this.
Again, it's the type of game where the feel of the combat is going to dictate whether or not it's
very much
paying
so
any attention to, really. But
yeah, that's what Ghost of Tsushima really nailed, was that combat feel, and it like feeling like heavy and weighty when you hit someone, you know. This does seem to have a much more sort of mythical element going along with it as well.
Yeah.
Which again, I'm not against in any capacity. It sort of looks like Ghost of Tsushima, but with what looks like quite cool boss fights, basically. Fair enough, man. Fair enough.
Yeah, interesting.
Not against that. Not against that at all. We've not had quite enough of people walking slowly and then falling over dead in this trailer now.
Oh, wow.
Wow, indeed. Again, if they nail the combat on that, that could be cool. There's no reason that couldn't be a really good game. Very cool.
Where wins meet? Again, so much new IP tonight. It's really cool. All right. Back when we started ONL in 2019, a very special guest joined me here in person to close the show. And this year, when I told him that we were going to be back here live in person, he said, well, I got to take part in some way. So Kojima. Please.
It does sound like Kojima, yeah.
My good friend, Hideo Kojima. Mr. Kojima?
He's not there in person. No, right? Is it? Spotify getting a nice plug there. Very good, very good. I'm Hideo Kojima. And we know, mate. Games with an S though. What? Kojima's got a podcast?
Both English and Japanese versions with simultaneous interpretation.
That's awesome. I'm definitely calling this the Kojima cast. I've literally written down in my notes Kojima cast deal.
Geoff's entertainment industry news section.
September the 8th, this is fucking fantastic. I cannot believe that we're getting a Hideo Kojima podcast advertise the Gamescom.
Bizarre.
What a lovely man he seems to be.
Welcome to our world, Hideo.
Yeah.
Last year, opening night live, we announced Park Beyond from Limbic.
Not even going to comment on that, Geoff. That insane announcement.
Awesome booth experience for those of you here in person. And for those of you at home, we've got a brand new trailer that shows you more of this incredible amusement park simulation game.
Is this, Christ, I can't remember the name of this game. That's so annoying. I can't get 2 Point Hospital out of my head. I don't know, that's not right.
Oh no, yeah, we saw this before.
Yeah. I mean, look, if you're into these sorts of games, maybe this is...
Aye.
All the business, but... I mean... it does seem like a ferocious waste of time.
I mean, that's not an argument we should be opening up this entire hobby. But
no, but I mean, even this more than most.
I've never understood how this can sustain your interest for that long. Like, I'm sure messing about with it for a wee bit, building something, you know, could be fun. But after a while, like, you know, unless you're extremely into theme parks, which I'm sure some people are.
Couldn't we go a step beyond? Ta-da.
I like how that man's version of a step beyond was a tall tower.
Yeah, just piles up on top. He's the Mark Zuckerberg of this world. We can just do something we've already got badly.
Was it Theme Park Tycoon or something like that? Was that the name of the game that I'm thinking of?
I mean, back in the day, Park Beyond next year. Then.
Park Beyond.
Yeah, back in the day, there was theme... Yeah, it was just so Theme Park the Builder or something, wasn't it? Like Theme Hospital and all that.
I love Theme Park back in the day.
Yeah, that is the game that I'm thinking of. Whatever that game is called, that's what I'm thinking of.
Another special announcement here at Gamescom. Not a game, but a concept car. That's right, it's here at Gamescom, and I got to catch
a
up
car. With Oliver Heimer, the head if of Elon design. Musk walks out right now, I'm fucking done this off, mate. Oh, thank God. It's just a weird Pokemon car.
I'm glad you like it. Well, let's take a look and learn more. in this trailer.
Why is this at Gamescom, Liz? Oh, God.
What have cars got to do with Pokemon?
Yeah, very little, I should imagine. You can get Pikachu on your dashboard, but... And is it projecting? Is that what it's doing there? Is it a car with a built-in projector?
But, I mean, oh, if it is, that's so completely cool.
I have
absurd.
So many questions for you, Oliver. First of all, I want to ask you about this partnership. A car with gaming features and Pokemon. How did this come together?
Yeah, first of all, let's talk about Gamescom. You know, yeah. Gamescom is one of the core events of femdom pop culture. And as we ourselves are a part
this is bizarre, Liz. Why is this here? Why is this here?
This is so daft.
Why is this here?
International, and we have a lot in common.
I mean, why wouldn't you? Why wouldn't you put this at like a Pokemon event or something like that? Do you know what I mean? Rather than
presumably, this is paying for Gamescom, you know, in part.
Well, I mean, we'll generate the money, sure, but I don't know why someone like Geoff Keighley can't turn around to them and go, "This is." Not the place for this, my man.
Well, because yeah, if the boss
this is not the kind of content we want at this showcase.
If Mini Cooper or whatever come to Gamescom's organizers and say, "We'll give you X amount of money towards your show if you'll let us advertise this absurd car we've built," that you know, that pays everyone's wages. That'll be why it's here. But it doesn't belong, and it feels like a big waste of time.
Sorry, that man just said you connect your games console to your Mini.
Just why would anyone want that?
I don't know. Like, remember when Teslas came out and they went nuts because it had Cuphead on it or whatever? Like, how many people are doing that? Like, how
once ever to
exactly
to
like?
Go, oh yeah, I can do that, and then moving on with your life.
Yeah, I mean, just how useful is that in a car? Like, not at all. Not at all. Like, it'd be such a faff to do. Like, rather than just piss about and play a game of something on your phone for 5 minutes while you're waiting, which is can be the only reason you would ever need that. Is just never stop playing.
Well, speaking of never stop...
Well, do stop playing when you're fucking driving, hopefully. Like, I mean, I'm all for playing as many video games as you can fucking get your hands on, but when you're driving, it's not the time.
So, stay tuned.
Awesome. All right, Oliver, thank you so much. We've got much Christ. More ONL still to come.
Oh, Geoff. That was a real low point, that.
He knows as well. Like, he knows that that's going to be pilloried, but they've just got to do these things, I guess, to make the show happen.
Oh. Surely there was someone else with some different money that he could have taken. Is this Warhammer 40k? Just Darktide, is that where it came up there?
I think so.
Right, I'm not surprised to see this, because this recently got delayed a little bit, and I think there's some scepticism about when the Xbox version of this is coming out, because it was supposed to be a day one Game Pass game. But it is actually coming out quite soon for PC, and it's been coming for forever. I mean, see if these sorts of games are your jam, where it's just sort of like waves, basically. Yeah. There's like lots of enemies and whatever. I mean, I think you can do worse than that, to be honest.
Yeah.
I also noticed, I think at the bottom there, it only said Steam once and Windows. I'm not actually sure it did say Xbox there, you know. Zora and Yaga. You got it all. Once upon a time, there was a freak with no face. Stop it! You can't hide from Baba, princess. I'm... How much longer you want to be... This is all kinds of weird. This is very weird. What you really want to find is... Yeah, it's got a really creepy vibe, bro. The hut. What the hell is wrong with this forest? Bow and arrows, not guns, Liz. Is that functionally better? I like how that exploded a rock.
If anything bad happens,
not a graphical powerhouse, but an interesting vibe they've built in the world there, we've got to say. Blacktail.
Some funny little pixel art animals there. Coming in this winter.
Something worth keeping your eye on. This really is atrocious. That's one of the worst adverts from anything I've ever seen. Red Bull gives you wings. I mean, that is one of the most low effort advertising of anything I've ever seen. I assume this is just an ad, basically.
Yeah, I think this whole section is really, but I think basically if Geoff's not saying anything beforehand, it doesn't really count.
Phantom Hellcat is a fucking cool name, though. Oh, Crossfire Rex. Well, we all know how this went first time round. Is this actually like DLC for that game?
I don't know. Is it like, because there's the multiplayer element and then there's the
Remedy story version.
And that was the bit that was getting absolutely slaughtered.
I mean, Crossfire X is, again, it's not particularly big in the West at all, but it's actually one of the most played, if not the most played game in the world, which is insane.
So presumably this is just
more content for that.
Yeah, new maps or whatever for the multiplayer part.
Cool.
Is that today then?
And now it is time for a really final award. But don't worry, there is more on Saturday, so make sure to not miss our award show on Saturday. But here are your nominees for the most wanted Sony PlayStation game.
Mel Hellslinger again. The Devil in Me. I'm not even sure if that is coming to PlayStation, you know?
I have no idea, actually. Yeah, it's got to be Lies of P here.
Lies of P feels... One Piece feels Odyssey. Like it should be Japanese, man.
And the winner is Lies of P.
Nice. I'm glad that won that.
The award is G1 Choi, project director at NeoWiz. The stage is yours.
Oh, thank you. First of all, I'm very proud of my team members, and we always do our best to live up to our team's name enough. And finally, do you know BTS? Like BTS in Korean pop, we'll be enough in the Korean gaming industry. Thank you. 감사합니다.
Thank you. Congratulations.
I'm going to be straight with you. I didn't hear much of what that man said.
Thank you so
However,
much.
His game looks fucking awesome.
For tonight. But before I say goodbye, I want to bring your attention to a more serious matter. The past 5 months of war have been devastating for the Ukrainian families, and UNICEF and partners on the ground.
I was wondering if they were going to say anything about this, to be honest.
And of course, funds are needed.
Been 6 months of war,
though. Consider donating at unicef.org if it's possible. And yes, we have to take care of each other.
Yeah, probably the semantics in this one, not super important. War has been going on for a while, they need fucking money.
Which was made for Syrian war refugees to learn the local language. And I mean, in times like this, it is more important than ever to take care of each other. And I hope you keep that in mind, not only for Gamescom this week, but way after. Thank you so much. That's it from me. And have a wonderful Gamescom. Geoff, back to you.
Thank you, Melly. Great to have you with us. We got a few more games to go. Now, one of the great things about Gamescom is we love to profile games made in Germany. And this next game was made by 4 students in Berlin. It was a big success on Steam, and now it's coming to a new platform, and we've got the announcement right now.
Sounds like something that's coming to Switch. Hey, there we go. is the goal here?
To be honest, I thought that was already on Switch.
I don't know what that game is, Lewis. Do you know what that game
is? Yeah, I've seen it before, yeah.
Cute, beautiful, now we're going to get dark. The Outlast Trials. You guys excited for this game? The Outlast Trials we showed you last year at Gamescom Opening Night Live, and we haven't heard anything since, really, from the team. And everyone keeps asking me, when are we going to get to play this? Well, tonight, we've got the world premiere of the brand new trailer, and yes, some news on when you might get to play it. Here we go.
What did he say this was?
The Outlast Trials.
Oh, right, yeah.
I don't really... I mean, he just said we saw it last year or whatever, so fair enough, but I don't really remember it.
I don't massively remember it either, to be honest, but... I mean, Outlast is a relatively...
Yeah, Outlast is Outlast. Yeah. It looks...
Well-known title in the horror genre. Looks exactly like what you would expect from that sort of game.
Do you think this is going to be a shadow drop? The way he was sort of laughing around that chat about the release date there made me think there's a big surprise coming.
That'd be cool. That'd be cool if it was. Might just be an early access thing or something. No, it's not really an early access sort of game, though, is it? Right in the forehead, that was. This isn't a multiplayer thing, is it? This is just a...
I have no idea, to be honest.
Like, single-player experience. Like, the other Outlast games were just that as well. Wasn't multiplayer elements to them, yeah.
But maybe this is more like a... You know, like a Dead by Daylight type thing or something.
Nah, well... Do you think you're getting that vibe from it?
Not like not especially, but just the name makes it feel
exactly.
Like it's
that's
a new skew.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. Like rather than just being like Outlast 3 or 4 or whatever it's up to.
Yeah. That, yeah.
Political criminals are subjected to a literally fatal dispensing of existence by the promise of execution.
Yeah,
closed beta. Yeah, closed beta.
That's right. Some people will get to play something this year, the Outlast Trials. All right. Next up, we've got a tease of the first release from Embark Studios, which a lot of the veterans that worked on the Battlefield franchise in Stockholm, Sweden. They've got a shooter wrapped in a game show format where destruction is going to play a key role. What we've got here is a short tease with some actual gameplay in it. The full reveal is coming later in September. You can sign up starting now to get in to start play tests of this. Check out the finals.
The finals. Oh, this was not the vibe I was expecting to see from this immediately.
Getting more in September, so there must be some other showcase coming. Interesting.
Oh, literally, that was the end of it. Okay.
Okay, yeah, fair enough.
All right.
That is a video
we
game.
Got one more game for you tonight at Gamescom Opening Night Live, and this is one we've all been waiting a long time for. Here we go.
Interesting. One more thing. That man looked like Lenny Kravitz.
I was thinking exactly that, yeah.
Is that man Lenny Kravitz?
It's certainly supposed to feel like him, isn't it?
Good grief. I don't know what this is, Los.
Is it going to be... What's the one that had that really famous trailer before, the kind of zombie game?
They had a really famous trailer.
Yeah, that was like a guy skating and there was all this madness going on behind him. And Goat Simulator parodied it recently.
Oh, I'm not sure.
Dead Island or one of those.
Oh, shit. Yeah, you might be right.
You'll totally know the trailer I'm talking about as well. I'll show it to you after this.
And the trailer was bad, or
no? It was like it was really wild. Well done, and right. You know, it sort of not what people were expecting. And then yeah, when Goat Simulator was revealed, whenever that was,
I had the goat on the skateboard. I didn't realize that was parody. Yeah, that. Oh, right, that's cool.
Yeah. Forgot he had a katana by the door.
So is this like, oh, Dead Island 2.
Dead Island 2.
It was like Dead Island, California.
Two coming next February, and joining me now to tell us about this long-awaited game is Khan. Khan, great to have you with us. First of all, let's explain a little context to that trailer we saw. Who is that character that we meet?
Thank you, Geoff. It's great to be here. So you just met Jacob, and he is just one of our six playable characters.
It definitely wasn't Lady Kravitz.
Our zombie slayers have larger-than-life personalities and unique dialogue, which fits in with a very pulpy and irreverent tone, as you could tell.
I see the tagline there, see you in Hell A, so it looks like we're heading to Los Angeles in this game?
Well, our pulpy tone is kind of a love letter to classic cult Hollywood horror B-movies, so where better to set it than in Los Angeles?
Did you ever play Dead Island, the first Dead Island? I know that folk absolutely loved it, loved it. But yeah. I never played it, never had any real interest in playing it. To be honest with you, that trailer didn't do a great deal for me either, but I know a lot of folk will be excited for that.
That's
so, I mean,
very
enough.
Much just establishing the same sort of tone as the first game had, I guess. But yeah, it was a big cult hit, I think, but it doesn't do a lot for me.
No.
It's the kind of game that I'm sure would be a good laugh to play of a night, but can't really imagine getting really sunk into it, you know?
No. Yeah, I mean, I would agree with you there, basically.
We think we've got a really great action RPG out of that.
So kind of surprised that it's coming out in February next year, and whether or not that gets pushed.
Yeah.
Seems likely to me.
Yeah, definitely.
Because they're still not showing any gameplay.
No.
Because I do sort of vaguely remember that trailer of a guy skating with a lot of kind of madness happening about in the background and whatever. And then that was sort of much the same.
Just the same idea.
You know, yeah.
Okay. Well,
I mean, I suppose February's still 6 months away or whatever. But
see some gameplay of it.
You want to see some gameplay?
They're going to show us some gameplay. Oh, very good, very good, very good.
How about now?
Okay, let's do it. Here's your first look at the gameplay of Dead Island 2.
They've undercut my point list. I hope this is good. Like, this is another one, like Saints Row, which seems to be reviewing very badly right now, ladies and gentlemen. But that I just hope is good for people that are like,
yeah,
it,
well,
you
that's
know what
it.
I mean? Because I think
a
lot of people will be
it,
like
yeah.
into this, you know? Despite the fact that like the chances of me playing this are extremely slim, I would say.
Stand the fuck back. It's hammer time.
Oh, that was nice. That was a nice touch. That was very pulpy. I like that. That was great.
Humanity's survival depends on the red gold pumping through my veins.
Well, sounds like you're the star of the show now.
This motherfucker.
I mean, I don't hate it, man. I don't hate it.
Like, as we've said with a couple of other games, it's just like, if you just want to run about causing carnage, fine. Like, that, you know, that can be loads of fun. And it, you know, I'm sure this would be totally a really good version of it, but...
To be honest with you, it is like the zombie version of Saints Row, do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's that sort of vibe like that, back in the day as well. Yeah.
It feels nuts that that's only the second Dead Island game, man. It feels like it's been around forever.
And believe it or not, there is an uncut version of that trailer you can watch online if you want to see even more. Dead Island 2 coming in February, and that is going to wrap up all the reveals for Gamescom Opening Night Live 2022. It's been a fun show, but before we go, I just want to say I hope everyone has a great Gamescom. There's lots of live streams for the next couple of days, lots of things for you guys to go and play and check out here on the show floor. And as for me and the team, well, we're going to go back to Los Angeles and get ready for the Game Awards 2022, which I'm excited to announce will be live on Thursday, December.
Oh, got a plug in for the Game Awards. There we go. He's only announced that date through the week.
You're on the Geoff Keighley marketing treadmill, aren't you, Mike?
Yeah. Very good.
Thank you, Geoff.
Very good, Geoff. Very good. Lewis, gut reactions?
Decent. There's some good looking games within that. I think my prediction that we weren't going to be blown away by very much is feels about right.
Yeah, I would totally agree. I've got to say, I'm pretty much the same. Yeah, there was some cool stuff in there. Was I blown away by much of it? No, not really, to be honest with you. But I think our prediction as well that it was going to be a lot of third party has also proven very, very right as
Absolutely,
well. Although we did get to see a cool PlayStation controller, which was interesting.
Yeah, odd that they would do that here out of everything. But and not a lot from Xbox, really. Like, pretty much just...
No, but they're having their own thing, so I sort of get that. Yeah. You know what I mean?
So...
Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, we have to go and record a podcast where we will be diving deeper into our favourites from Gamescom Opening Night Live. You can find that podcast on anywhere you get your podcast. It's just called the PlayersToo Podcast. And it will also be on this year very YouTube channel. Right, ladies and gentlemen, we will see you when we see you. We're going to try and do more video stuff in the future, but I think I said that last year when we did this, and this is the next thing that we've done. So,
yeah.
Cheerio.
See you at the Game Awards.
Bye.